Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. You're welcome. I hope you enjoyed our video on the Islamic perspective on music. So inshallah, we're going to be looking at the functions of musical instruments. So what are musical instruments? Musical instruments are tools that can be used to produce musical and non-musical sounds. So any instrument that can be used to produce musical sounds or non-musical sounds are called what? Musical instruments. We have different types of musical instruments. We have the Western musical instrument and we have the African musical instrument, which are otherwise known as the local musical instrument. So let's look in our book and see some of other things we can learn here. Music is better made and danced to when accompanied by musical instruments. Musical instruments generate sounds which, when combined with songs, become more melodious or pleasant to hear. There are different kinds of musical instruments. Musical instruments can also be classified into different ways by their societal status. So a musical instrument can be classified by how the society sees that musical instrument. Some musical instruments have cultural values and some are actually used by a particular group of people. They can also be classified by the material that they are made of. So we have different materials being used to make different musical instruments. They can be used, classified by the role they play, as well as the sound they produce. So these are the four classifications we can actually use to classify musical instruments. Let's say them again: social status, materials used to making them, the sound they produce, and the role they play in music. Let's look at the Western musical instruments. So we have different types of Western musical instruments. We have the woodwind, the brass, the percussion, string, and keyboard. Each of these musical instruments have their own functions and their characteristics. Let's look at the woodwind family. So we have the flute, the oboe, the clarinet, the basson, the saxophone, and the English horn. So all this, they are actually air-producing musical instruments. I'm sure you're familiar with a flute. The oboe is similar to a flute, but it's longer. And then we have the clarinet. We have the saxophone. We also have the brass family. So the woodwind, they look something like this. They're thin. The brass usually have a wide mouth opening. It's actually a wide mouth opening in brass instruments. So we have the trumpet. I'm sure you've seen a trumpet before amongst the brass family. We have the flugelhorn, we have the French horn, we have the trombone, and the euphonium and tuba. So these are some of the instruments that are actually part of the brass family. We also have the percussion family. So these musical instruments, we have the timpani, the snare drum, brass drum, triangle, piano, and xylophone. I'm sure you've seen a xylophone before. Yes, you hit all these. The percussion are musical instruments that are being hit. We have the string family, boom, 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 like the guitar, violin. So we have the violin, the piano, the harp. Yes, remember the harp? The harp, like the harp that will be played in Jack and the Beanstalk. The harp looks something like this. And there are strings coming down just like that. Exactly. So that is what? The harp. And finally, we have the keyboard. So in the keyboard, we also have the organ, the piano, we have the accordion, and the xylophone. So the xylophone is also part of the keyboard because it actually has keys, just like the piano. They have what? Keys. Okay, let's see. It is important to know that some instruments belong to more than one family. Like we've seen, the reason may be because of the way they are constructed, the way they are played, or the way they produce musical sounds. So they belong to part of more than one based on these reasons. So if you look in your book, figure 17.1, you'll see pictures of keyboard, conga, and trumpet. You can see that the trumpet is a brass instrument with a wide mouth opening. And we have the conga, which is a percussion. You hit it like a drum. And we have the keyboard. Can you see all that? Good. Now let's go into local musical instruments. Local, we have Africa amongst as the local samples we're looking at. So for us, Africa is the bass. So these are musical instruments played to accompany Nigerian or traditional African songs and music. Have you ever been to a place where maybe people are having a party and all of a sudden you see some old men with their musical instruments trying to entertain people to earn money? Oh, it used to be very, very rampant in the past. I don't know how much people still do that today. So we have the membranophones. The membranophones are drums and all instruments made with animal skin. Animal what? Skin. So all these are what? Membranophones. If you look in your books, you can see the talking drum. People will actually believe that the talking drum talks. And we have the rattle. They can be single or double ended, e.g. the talking drum, the tambourine, the congas, the woogie gong, and so on. So these are membranophones. We also have idiophones. Idiophones are what? Slit drum, xylophone, gong, bell, piano, and so on. So these ones are what? Idiophones. Is that clear? These African instruments are called idiophones. We have chordophones. Chordophones are what? Chords. These are musical instruments that look like what? A bow. Remember, like the harp I drew on the board. So these things are actually called what? The chords. So these chordophones look like what? A bow used by hunters and are what? Connected to a box that makes listeners hear the sound. So we have strings running from the top to the bottom, and then there's a connection at the bottom. If you look in your book, you see different types of harps. We mentioned harps as also part of what? Western musical instruments. And we have the sitar. Remember the sitar? Look here, the sitar looks like what? Very good, like the guitar. And we have, finally, among the African musical instruments, we have the aerophones. The what? Aerophones. These are instruments that are played by either vibrating the lips or blowing into an air enclosure. Blowing into what? An air enclosure. So the lips can be vibrated, like some that you put on the lips and you go foo 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 foo, or one that you just blow foo foo foo. Any of them, these are what? So the flute is an example of what? An aerophone. And you can see different types of flutes in your book. Can you see them? Very good. So let's look at the functions of this musical instrument. We've looked at the different types, the ones from the Western and the ones from local. Now let's look at the functions. There are different types of functions. We have two major functions. Remember, I said musical instruments can be classified based on functions, musical and non-musical what? Functions. So what are the musical functions? The musical instruments are used to accompany songs during religious worship or celebration. Is that clear? So these are the musical functions. They used to accompany songs. They're also used to produce musical sounds. Like the piano, without any song, you can actually produce a musical sound from the piano or even the flute. Many people have played the flute. I've recited the national anthem using the flute without actually singing the words with it. So you can use it to produce sound on its own. You can also use it to entertain guests. So because it's music, it uses it to entertain guests. So like those men I mentioned that go about in parties, they don't sing anything. They don't have any music from their mouth, but they actually use their musical instruments to entertain guests. We can use it to what? Play songs in concerts. record songs in the studio. You can use it to sing people's praises. People do that, especially in the olden days, in traditional settings. People want to praise a person of reputation in the country, in the state or the locality. They use drums and musical instruments to praise the person. And we can use it to what? Introduce or accompany advertisements. So these are the musical functions of what? These musical instruments. What are the non-musical functions? The non-musical functions include to call for action. For example, when people are called to war or called to attention, maybe during the national Armed Forces Day, musical instruments actually played there. They're not actually used for musical purposes, but for non-musical purposes. So we have, for example, military and paramilitary groups play trumpets or bugles to assemble their members for parade or war. It goes easy to call or attract attention. Easy call attract. For example, the bell is a musical instrument, but it's used in many schools to actually let the students know when a period is over or another period is starting. So it can be used to actually call people's attention. Or it can also be used to deliver important messages, just like the gong is used in a village square to deliver the king's messages. You can use it by, it's used by market men and women to attract your customers. Musical instruments are also used for decoration in some cultures. You go to some people's homes and you find drums hung on the wall or pianos as a decorative item in their living room. So these are some of the functions. They're used as symbols. Some companies associate musical instruments with their products. For example, Starcom's telecommunications uses the talking drum as a logo, while Nigerian Breweries PLC uses what? The harp. So some people use it as what? A means of identification, so as a symbol. It can also be used as what? Gift items. You want to give people give themselves gift items or musical instruments, and it can be used to what? Communicate. In Oyo time, for example, the sound of glass drum, which is the dun dun, ensemble in the morning means that the Alaafin has woken up. Also, the flute of the Igbos and Yorubas glass drum can be used to communicate with other human beings. So, let's quickly look at the last part of our video, which is the materials for constructing musical instrument. I want you to read more on that. Let me just quickly go through it with you. So we have different types of musical instruments and where they are made. And these are some of the materials used in making them. Puffer stock. People use puffer stock to make flute. I did that when I was younger anyway. You just cut out the stock, you cut out the leaf part, and then you also cut out the end of the stock. Then you make little incision in measured spaces, distances, and when you blow and cover any part, it brings out different sounds. People can use a wooden clapper, calabash gourd, use a gong, a bell, reed, animal skin, like I said, for drums, the talking drums, clay and animal horns. So all these materials can actually be used to make what? Local instruments. I want you to look in page 68, where you see pictures of different musical instruments. I just want you to know them for academic purposes. Remember, the Islamic stance on music is prohibition. But for academic purposes, I want you to learn them so that you can actually excel in your academics. May Allah increase you in knowledge. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.